Hello, my name is Dr. Kelly Moore, and I am president and CEO of immunize.org, a nonprofit organization that supports healthcare professionals with immunization education. My institution, immunize.org, has received honoraria from the following companies for my work on advisory boards. Before my talk begins, I want to briefly acknowledge CDC's recommendations for hepatitis B vaccination and screening. Risk-based recommendations first began in 1982. Routine recommendations for all people at specific ages were added, along with updates to risk categories over time, as shown here. Currently, CDC recommends routine catch-up vaccination of all people age 59 years and younger, with vaccination of older adults when desired or if at risk. In 2023, CDC recommended that every adult age 18 years or older be screened at least once in a lifetime with a triple panel screening test: hepatitis B surface antigen, anti-hepatitis B core antibody, and anti-hepatitis B surface antibody. In my role, I receive many questions about hepatitis B vaccination of adults. In this lecture, I'd like to review the answers to five common but important questions about hepatitis B vaccination, plus one bonus question. Here's the first and most basic question about catch-up vaccination of adults. Why should healthcare professionals focus on vaccinating all adults against hepatitis B now? The bottom line is this: anyone can be infected with hepatitis B, and everyone can benefit from knowing their status and being protected. The majority of adults reported to CDC with acute hepatitis B in recent years have no reported risk factor for infection. Risk factors for exposure are so numerous and diverse that most adults, even those who don't think of themselves as at risk, may find themselves at risk at some point in their lives. Infants and children have been routinely vaccinated since the 1990s. As a result, we see very little hepatitis B in the routinely vaccinated age groups. However, rates have been steady or climbing in unvaccinated older adults. CDC recommends extending this vaccine protection to all adults in a catch-up vaccination program. This is a crucial step toward the goal of eliminating hepatitis B and the liver disease and cancer it causes. The next question is related to practices implementing both hepatitis B screening and vaccination programs for adults. If the patient hasn't been screened for hepatitis B yet, should you screen them before you decide about vaccinating? It seems tempting to wait for screening test results, but since this is a 2 or 3 dose series that most adults need, we do not generally recommend missing an opportunity to vaccinate. Vaccination today helps protect a person who needs it. There is no specific risk related to vaccinating a person who does not need it due to pre-existing immunity or infection. Even for specialists who work with patient groups with an increased likelihood of past infection, such as people who use injection drugs, we encourage administering the first dose just after drawing blood for screening at the same visit when feasible. If results show no further vaccination is needed, then the vaccine series can be stopped at that point. If the results show further vaccination is needed, as it will with most people, then only one or two more doses will be needed to complete the series. This next question addresses a common issue for people who have the routine triple panel hepatitis B virus screening test years after being vaccinated. Does everyone who was properly vaccinated need to be revaccinated if their anti-HBs is negative on the triple panel screen? For most people, the answer is no. A negative anti-HBs result is a common finding when tested years after completing vaccination and most healthy people may be reassured that they would still be protected from illness if exposed. Antibody titers naturally drift lower over the years. However, studies have shown that the majority of people who were effectively immunized decades earlier can mount an effective antibody response and prevent symptomatic or chronic infection after exposure. A study of members of the Alaska Native population published in 2022 estimated that 86% had effective protection 35 years following vaccination. Even those few with serologic evidence of hepatitis B infection at some point after vaccination showed no evidence of active infection, which is the most important health outcome. Revaccination is indicated for certain people at ongoing high risk, as specified in the 2018 ACIP recommendation. Examples include non-responder infants born to people who tested positive for hepatitis B surface antigen, healthcare providers at risk of occupational exposure, and people on hemodialysis or with significant immunocompromise. For further details, see the 2018 ACIP recommendation, pages 23 and 24, on the link at the bottom of the slide. Now, this is a practical question that comes up in many clinics that are preparing to implement both hepatitis B screening and vaccination of adults. If giving hepatitis B vaccine and drawing the screening HBV triple panel serology at the same visit, does it matter which you do first? The answer is yes, it matters. Draw the blood for screening first. It is possible to detect hepatitis B surface antigen from the Hep B vaccine in serologic tests up to 18 days after vaccination. So CDC recommends obtaining blood for the screening triple panel before administering the first dose of vaccine to avoid any chance of a false positive Hep B surface antigen result. Alternatively, wait 1 month after administration of the most recent dose of hepatitis B vaccine. If screening is done after initiating the vaccine series, but before series completion, note that you should complete the vaccination series unless the screening test shows evidence of past infection. Durable vaccine-induced immunity requires completion of the Hep B vaccine series. This question raises another practical issue. What do I do if a patient had the first Hep B dose in the series years ago, but never finished it? It's not uncommon to encounter a patient who initiated the hepatitis B vaccine series a long time ago, but never completed it. If you have no documentation of the vaccination and the history is based only on a patient's recollection, start the series as if the patient were unvaccinated. CDC recommends doing this to avoid the risk of incomplete vaccination as a result of a patient's faulty recollection. If you have documentation that the Hep B vaccine dose was given, even if given in childhood, simply pick up the series with the next dose due. It is acceptable to complete Hep B vaccination with a mixed product series when necessary, whether because the brand administered first is not available or the brand of the earlier dose was not documented. If the first dose was Heplisav B by Dynavax, indicated by H on this table, then one additional dose of Heplisav B completes the series. Two more doses are needed if the series is completed with a different brand of Hep B vaccine, Injurix B, Prehevbrio, Recombivax, or the Twinrix combination Hep A, Hep B vaccine, or if the first dose was not Heplisav B. Depending upon the products available, you may either initiate a two-dose Heplisav B series with a four-week minimum interval, or complete the three-dose series with any other age-appropriate Hep B vaccine using an eight-week minimum interval between doses 2 and 3. For additional details, refer to the CDC's current recommended immunization schedule for adults, available at the link shown. And here's the bonus question. Most people will only need to complete hepatitis B vaccination once in their lifetime. Given the recommendation to ensure vaccination of everyone through the age of 59 years, you can imagine that lost records have the potential to become a widespread issue, making it harder to target those who really need vaccination. Documentation is crucial to the success of the adult Hep B catch-up vaccination program. First, give the vaccine recipient a personal record. Let them know that taking a digital photo of their record is wise. Second, all states have an immunization information system known as an IIS or immunization registry. Check the IIS for the patient's vaccination records and ensure that your workflow includes reporting of vaccine doses administered to the IIS to ensure a permanent record of vaccination exists that is accessible to other healthcare providers who need the information. This is the best way to minimize unnecessary vaccination in the future. Thank you for taking the time to review the questions in this mini lecture with me. Please see the website for additional mini lectures.
The production of this Hepatitis B online mini lecture was supported by funding from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention.